And welcome back. This is the RPG Chick. Yes, we activate all our little powers. Thank you very much. We are exploring the Old Song District, just looking around, looking at stuff. Nothing much here. This way lies to a dragon. Not going there anytime soon. Got Noonfrost area and Burial Isle. Burial Isle is full of shades and stuff. Gonna try to keep this episode a little shortish because I only have 155 gigs left on my hard drive, and believe it or not, that fills up rather quickly. So I guess we're going to go into Galawain's Maw? Is this lead outside the city? Should I be sneaking?
Time to see and not be
Let's sneak. And interrupt party members. I got the little cave thing going on there when the icon. So, oh, we're completely seen, so, let's drop all pretense of that. Fangs Huntress. A lot of fangs people here. Persevere, Estremor, and may your beast grow within. Thank you, I think. Gives you a stiff nod. The enemy won't something or other, because you're a stiff nod. Again, I'm interrupting them. I hate when I do that. But again, why would you come over to them unless to talk to them?
Got it.
This huntress sizes you up with a casual glance.
Rensi has no right to defend that cowering cat in the back of the mall.
Then track her down and tell her yourself.
Hmm. Interesting. You went that way. Bear clanswoman. Gruffed and unkempt, this barbarian's hair spills over her shoulders. This barbarian stares at you, his eyes brimming with restrained fury. Einden?
Come to see the great Oernos, Estremor? He's out for a hunt, but he'll be back. Unlike that lioness, he doesn't stay cooped up in here for long.
Sorry, guys. There's rearranging everything here on my head. The man meets your gaze with a challenge in his eyes. Why can't Oranos go and fight the lioness?
Because she holes up at the back of the maw, surrounded by her pride and the natural hazards of this place. It's not the proper way to meet a challenger. She's got to come out and face Oranos to keep her claim. Anyway, her prime is past. Putting that old beast down would be a mercy at this point.
What are you doing here?
We wait for the big confrontation, but the wait grows exhausting. While Sul hides in the back of the maw, Oernos is denied his victory, and we're all denied the champion we deserve.
He grimaces and runs his thumb along the edge of his axe. I could take care of Sul. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to be doing. Convincing her? His callous thumb makes a scraping noise against the blade of his axe. I hate to spoil the tradition of a big showdown, but if she retreats from her fight, then there's no point in waiting. Kill her, and that'll be proof enough that she's not a fit companion. Kill her? He sighs, spinning his axe by the shaft. Too much waiting. Something's gotta happen. Soon. Galawain is a god of both hunter and prey. Firebrand finishes escorting Lord Brynregar and returns to his stronghold. Good. Stiff nod. And we got fog of war going on here. Larha? The Hunter of the Fangs moves with cat-like grace. Exceptional Morning Star. A proper key. May their blood freeze in their veins, she says.
Estramore.
An Orland woman stands ankle deep in the sand, sharpening a spearhead. You must be Bethel's new Estramore. Truth, when I heard she'd let another in, I almost went to the Passage of the Six myself to share words. She points the flint spearhead at you. Have other foreigners come this way recently? Glamfellen. Worshippers of Rimagand, they claim. Simply looters and defilers by another name. That's the truth. The spearhead flashes as she shakes it at the door. They disappeared behind the doors of Noonfrost, and now our lake turns to ice and the cold creeps ever closer. She digs a trench in the sand with one bare foot. Yet Bethel is timid, and she has convinced the other Anamphather that we must respect these Estramorin and their traditions, no matter what mischief guides their hands. She raises her head, slowly looking back toward the entrance. I'm guessing you didn't leave it at that. I sent my own sister, one of my finest scouts, to sniff out the Pale Elf's corruption. I was certain the Anamphatha could not ignore the defilement in Noonfrost once Alwa's own eyes had seen it, but she still hasn't returned. She looks away. Now I bear the responsibility for her fate, and I can't send the Fangs after her without openly defying the Anamphatha. Tell me about the Maw. An ancient place of beasts and dangers. As followers of the Clever Hound, we assemble and train here as hunters, warriors, and defenders of the Builder's sacred places. Chaos pervades the Maw, and more than ever due to this stalemate between the beasts. She shakes her head. But Deathwin refuses to intervene, and many itch to settle the matter over blood. What are you doing here? My stocks equip my brethren in the Fangs, and my hands train them to fight, hunt, and track with skill. What purpose brings you here? I could look for Alwa. She gives you a guarded look. I don't dare to hope. Whatever catastrophe has befallen Noonfrost does not feel like the work of Kith. But nothing would bring me greater joy than seeing her again. She glances at the sand and frowns. I would take any assistance you can give. Do you have any supplies for sale? Only the finest. Bleak Fang. Unique stiletto. Grants touch of rot on critical hit. One per encounter. Nasataki Huntress was tracking game, or a Nasataki Huntress was tracking game, with the other wives of her tribe when a terrible blizzard separated her from the rest of the party. Starving and nearly snowblind, she ate the leather of her gloves to fill her belly while she searched for food. As her strength was fading, she came upon the corpse of a caribou, frozen and half-gnawed by Arctic foxes. She ate her fill and, exhausted, fell into a deep sleep. When she awoke, she saw the fingers of her left hand stricken with a numbing corruption. As she journeyed back in the direction of her village, she watched the corruption spread across her knuckles and across her hand. Unwilling to succumb to it, she took her stiletto and cut her hand off at the wrist. Rhaegar Kanek. A unique hatchet. Plus 20% attack speed. 10% of hits converted to crits. Plus 5 deflection and accuracy against human, Omawa, Orlan, godlike, dwarf, and elf. Plus 25% damage against human, Omawa, Orlan. Got the same. After enduring a series of Zorup raids, a small Glamfellen clan near Maiden Falls requested aid from the legendary scouts of the Fisher Crane tribe of Thane Bog. Such was the cunning of the scouts that they ambushed the Zorups in their own caves. One of the quickest Orlan warriors slaughtered the Zorup chieftains with his own hatchet, naming it Rhaegar Kanek, Clever Cutter, in honor of the victory. Waitaki. Battle Axe. Plus 30% damage. Crits can inflict prone. Hailing from the lands of Ratai, Waitaki, or Water Axe, is covered in traditional spiraling symbols for water and the sea. Omawa craftsmen sought to instill the axe with the same power of a rolling wave, striking foes with sudden fearsome force. When the axe is swung, it is said, the twisting symbols undulate like the waters of the Great Eastern. Fine stuff, exceptional stuff. Red field. A medium shield. 12 deflection minus 4 accuracy, plus 4 shield deflection grants Harbinger. Passive. Which is a faux AoE minus 3 accuracy for 3 seconds versus Will. Only 3 seconds. This battered shield saw use in one of the bloodiest battles of the Broken Stone War, after which it fell into Glanfathan hands. Though the shield's name first referred to the original bearer's heraldry, these days it serves as a reminder of the sea of corpses that once littered the fields of the Deerwed. The shield retains its vibrant hue, and the flash of crimson often proves a distraction to foes. 7 Scolder's Worth. Look at that, unique light armor. Plus 2 stealth and plus 1 move speed. A rural Deerwooden legend holds that armor crafted from the hide of the nocturnal secretive Scolder imbues the wearer with preternatural stealth. Determined to best every like-minded fellow to test this superstition before him, one enthusiastic hunter crafted this hide from no fewer than 7 Scolders. Though it is unclear what effect the quality had, or quantity had, the result is a dark-hued armor that blends undeniably well with the shadows. Flask of War Paint. Plus 15 accuracy, plus 10% damage, 20% maximum endurance for 20 seconds. Binding the essence of sacrificed lives into a potent brew of blood and magic, War Paint by the Ethic Gnoll has empowered Glanfathan warriors to perform great feats of strength and dexterity for hundreds of years. Let's take a pry bar, a hammer and chisel just in case, flint and tinder. Oh, lockpicks, yes, all of them. Just in case we need them. Alua went to the Temple of Noonfrost looking for answers. She hasn't returned. Larha, a member of the Fang, sent her sister to investigate, and she hasn't returned. She believes the pale elves who recently came to the temple may be the source of this. I may be able to find Alua or evidence of her disappearance in Noonfrost. Okay. That's done. Okay.
And what does the flame reveal?
Large open space, looking for secrets. Doesn't appear that there are any. I'm like, why are these guys sneaking around? We already know they're here. The stones at the edge of the chasm are slick and beaded with moisture.
Nice and quiet.
An old war bow. All of life is a hunt. We pursue sustenance while death pursues us. There's a Deshwin person. Book of the Hunt. I have that. Bone pins pierce the hide map at a handful of locations along the Glanfathan side of the Bale River. Stealing. Boiling spray, ooh.
Look, Estramor, this is no place for sightseeing.
The beasts of Galawain's Maw are dangerous. And now more than ever. If you want to see some pretty Glamfellen places, go to Elm's Reach.
A wiry elven man paces the cavern, his face etched with worry lines and his hand irritably thumping his hip. He looks at you and his exasperation deepens. This is Galawain's Maw?
Yes, a den of beasts sacred to the Lord of the Hunt himself. Historically, the greatest predator of Air Glanfoth has claimed the back of the Maw as its lair. Lately, however, there's been some dispute as to who should occupy that position. And it's leading to discord among our hunters.
Something else? I prefer action to talk, but I'll answer your questions as best I can. What's wrong with the beasts?
They won't fight.
He stops pacing and turns to you. What's wrong with that?
It is not Galawain's way, and it is not the way of the Maw.
The Maw has always been home to one great predator. Every so often, a challenger comes along, and the two battle for territory. But Sul remains in her den, and Aranos can't confront her there. Now, two mighty predators and their kin hunt from the same stock. It's thinning the herds, and it's thinning patience around here, too. He resumes his pacing. And this waiting. It's not the deliberate, watchful waiting of a hunter lying in ambush. It's stagnation. Tedium. Hoping for something to happen. He clenches his hands into fists. But I'm powerless to act. One half of the fangs will cry favoritism if I try to drag the lioness out myself. I want to know about the two predators. There's never been a more cunning hunter than Sul, but some say she's losing her edge. Aranos, on the other hand, is all edge, and many of our number think he's the rightful successor. His fingers drum a restless rhythm on his thigh. Blood simmering. It's going to boil over if a little doesn't spill soon. Would you favor Sul or Aranos? He frowns. I see both sides. Sol's cunning is unmatched, but Aranos is the mightier of the two. Both embody traits praised by Galawain. I am an unbiased outsider. I could look into it. And a fierce one from the looks of you. He scratches his cheek. No harm in letting you try, I suppose. Anything's better than this restless waiting. Endless waiting, rather. If you somehow bring this to a resolution, those tensions will end. If not, he grins, the beasts will make short work of you. He gives you a heavy iron key. We don't normally permit ourselves to venture into the Maw, but you understand that you do so at your own risk, and Sol's lions are likely to attack intruders on sight. Still, perhaps you can coax her into fighting the bear. Do whatever you can to end this stalemate. Let's talk about something else. Such as? Tell me about yourself. I am the leader of the Fangs. We're an order of hunters and warriors devoted to Galawain, and we see that the places of the builders remain pure. Not truly a tribe, but we do gather and argue like one. Our members come from all of the tribes, but most of us were born three Tusk Stelgar, Fisher Crane, and Keepers of the Stone, naturally. Where could I find Sul? Straight at the back of the Maw. He points down the halls on either side of him. You could get through either way, but mind where your feet step. The Maw is a dangerous place, and Sul's pride and her advocates are on the alert. And where is Aranos? Good question. Bear's out hunting right now, but he'll return soon. He's never gone for long. So the hunter's actually a lioness and a bear, not people.
Let's see what lies this way.
don't suppose... Maybe if we finish this quest, he'll leave the area and we can get this. Alright, I guess we should go and look for this person. Or, well, this beast. We're not going to finish it this episode. Just going to take a little peek. Because 20 minutes is kind of short.
And what does the flame reveal?
Yeah.
Get some beasts. There's a lion. Yeah, it's Kanna. He's always a little behind.
Following your lead.
We love him, though. Lion clansman. Do you know he wants to use his bare fist? That's just, you know. That's him. Soul ignition. Alright, so we've got two lions and two lion clansmen. Okay, it's running around, so I dare knock this one down instead. Oh, we chunked that thing. Oh, knock him down, actually. Oh, that one's almost dead? Hmm. Then... on that one. Turned into a, he's a werelion. That's pretty cool. I didn't think that would happen. And I bet he didn't think that would happen.
No problem. My eyes are peeled.
Hmm. Oh, what's up here? Oh, it's the Old Song District? Okay. Well, we're not leaving yet. There's another lion.
Yes?
What are we dealing with here? Lion, lioness, lioness. Ooh, we killed it already. Nice. Oh, another one's joining the fray. Dara, you can take this one on. I'm on... kinda.
Following you.
Oh, canna. Adair, you fight that one. We honor you, great hunters, but we slay you just the same.
Wait!
Ooh, trap detector that way. Let's check this way, though.
Flame and sound.
We'll keep to ourselves.
Well, they said to watch us for us to watch our feet. Oh boy, another one.
Something over there. What? That's settled.
Awesome. Well, let's go this way.
No problem.
That's settled.
Every time you get experience, it's worth it.
Sure.
Ooh, what's that? Trap.
And the fire shows me something new.
Oh! The fire shows you these guys. Alright, we can't cross that, obviously. Well, he was about to change into a were-lion, wasn't he? But he didn't.
Nice and quiet.
And now you can disarm this thing.
That's settled. If it makes you rest easier.
Let's check out this first. Ooh. Remains of a broken bridge, long collapsed, lead to a deep chasm. The other side of the bridge pierces through the mist at the far end of the chasm, hanging precariously over the steep fall. Examine the area. The broken stones of the bridge, weathered after centuries of disrepair, are scattered along the edge and side of the chasm. A thin mist rises from below. The stones are coated with slick green moss, making them impossible to grip safely. The wooden beams lodged between the stones on the other side of the bridge seem, on either side of the bridge, seem sturdy enough to support your weight, however. Well, I'm not leaving. Yeah, that's the way back. Well, it's one way back.
I shall be discreet.
Camp, yep. Okay, we're not all...
laying low.
There we go.
Something over there.
All this experience from the traps, it's awesome. A lion clanswoman.
Yes?
All right, fine, hit that one. Oh, wow. Elder lions. Hope I don't run out of this space here. He is badly injured, though. That's good to say. She should be smart about this. You can finish him off that way. Who's in front? Palagina? We all have our orders.
Yes.
This guy's still standing. Okay. Not sure when I used all that up. Chunkage. Fireball here. Elder Lion Fang. Just tells us about lions, though.
Got it.
Okay. Ooh. Guess we can explore the rest of this area first.
Slowly now.
I'm hoping my disc doesn't run out, but...
Now this... I haven't seen before.
Oh, you're almost stepping on it. Is it because she's in his way?
I'm ready.
Yeah, you're a little too ready. Failing, huh? Alright.
Fine.
He's like, fine. Failing. What is this? No, this way. No!
I'm ready.
My God.
I understand. Yeah?
You don't understand anything. No. A thick, snarled tangle of dagger-sharp thorns and vines has grown across this passage. As you look on, the entire wall of vegetation seems to move, almost like it were breathing. Thick coils of vines twist and writhe across the gap with a quiet rustle of foliage. Examine the vines. Through the gaps in the twisting vegetation, you catch brief glimpses of what seems to be a wide circular chamber. From time to time, you catch sight of tawny hides, and the rustling of vines is briefly obscured by low growls. Okay. And there's a bridge this way. Wait. Doesn't that go back? And there's a bridge also this way? Aha. Okay. So I got two ways to go. Through here and across the bridge. You're gonna go through the bridge. Well, across the bridge next episode. Thanks for watching. See you next time and endure. In enduring, grow strong.